Thanks, Ron. Okay, so first up, thanks so much for coming out. The year has just begun, and there are n number of things you could have been doing right now, but you choose to come here. So thank you very much for that. I want to thank Paul. I want to thank Chris. I want to thank Dan for setting this up and giving me this opportunity to talk to you about two of the things that I love the most. One is obviously music, and the other is JavaScript Node.js. So I'm really excited about it, and thank you for coming down. The other thing is, like he mentioned, my name is Walmik. I work for PayPal. I'm a software engineer, and we are hiring right now. If anybody's interested, just hit me up, and I'll see what I can do about that. Okay, so let's get started. I don't have much time. I've just got 30 minutes, and I've got too many things to share. So I'll jump right into it. So I wanted you to see this GIF, you know? I took some time. See, that's why I wanted it back. Okay. So so I'll just get right to it. So first up, who dabbles with music over here? Like anybody make music, create music? It can be anything. You don't have to be like a full-on music producer or something. You could have like a guitar that you bought 6 years ago. It's lying there in the corner now. Okay, and you don't even touch it. But that's fine. You wanted to do music someday. Okay, perfect. So there are some people. What about people who listen to music? Okay, forget making music. You like to listen to music. Anybody? Yeah. Okay, most. Okay, so almost all. So there's a gap, obviously, in people who are making music and people who create music. If that gap can go down by even one today, I'll think this presentation will have kind of succeeded. Okay, so like I mentioned, I like music and I like JavaScript, and I try to find some ways to put them together, which is what I did with Scribbletune. So Scribbletune is obviously open source. It is on GitHub. We are inside GitHub. That's a double whammy right there. It helps you create music with JavaScript strings and array functions. So a lot of it is already known to you. It's nothing really new. And the other thing is you can use note names and chord names and scale names. If you have dabbled with music, you would know what I'm talking about. You can use that directly in your code. You can import Lodash or underscore, use all of that to mangle your arrays and build some complex structures. I will not get into complex structures today, but you can do all of that. If you have not dabbled with music before, that may not have made sense to you, but the next point probably will make sense to you. It has a ridiculously minimalistic API. There are only three methods in Scribbletune. There is one more, but we can leave that for now. So there are these three methods that you actually use. So it's a very small API. There's three methods, and you can get started. Okay, and this is the most important point. It contributes towards making our society safe and secure for us and our children. And I'm not kidding. I'll prove it by the end of this presentation. I hope I will. Okay. This is like a sample code. I will do some live coding, but just to get you started, this is sample code. This is the smallest bit of code you'll write when you're making music with Scribbletune. The first line is pretty self-explanatory. You must have written at least 100 times, something like that, at least 100 times before, if not 1,000. The next line is an introduction to the first method of Scribbletune, which is called the clip. So we're just putting scribble.clip inside a variable called c. That clip method has only one object as its argument. And that object lets you add parameters to that clip. So in this case, it's adding the first parameter called notes. It's an array, as you can see, and it's using the just one note right now, C4. That's the C note on the fourth octave. And just doing that will create a clip with that C4 note in it. And the next method is scribble.midi, where you export that clip into a MIDI file. This MIDI file you can import into GarageBand, Ableton Live, Fruity Loops, Reason, Cubase, whatever that you use to make music, you can import that and you can use it. If you are using a Mac, you already have GarageBand on it. So you can get started like right away. So if I play that, what it sounds like. Yeah. That's it, ladies and gentlemen. That's Scribbletune. Thank you very much. Okay, obviously, I'm kidding. I mean, that's not it. There's a lot more to it. And it would be really ridiculous if I end my talk right now. So let's move on. Now it's the same kind of function. It's just that I've added one more parameter called pattern. Patterns are pretty important when it comes to Scribbletune, because if you listen to electronic dance music, and what is the most common thing about electronic dance music? Anybody? Bass. Okay, anything else? Anything more intrinsic to the music? Repetition. Someone read the page of SFNode. Okay, yeah, it's repetitive. And we're engineers. What do we what do we think of when we see something repeating again and again and again and again? What do we do? Automate the damn thing. you don't okay, I don't want to criticize musicians today, but you can just use JavaScript and you can automate all that repetitive stuff. At least you can abstract that much out and you can focus only on the creative aspect of it, the melodies or something like that. So going back to this, it's the same function. The note is still C4, and now we're giving it a pattern. That pattern is made up of just X and hyphens. There is also an underscore. We'll leave that for now. But basically, X minus X minus X minus X, what it does is note on, note off, note on, note off, note on, note off. And there are 16 of them over there. In electronic dance music, every bar is made up of 16 beats. You can obviously change that, but by default, it's 16 beats. So that is 16 beats over there. If I play that, obviously. So it took that note and it played every time it saw an X, and every time it saw a minus or a hyphen, it kind of did nothing about it. So it played like that. What we can do is, since it's an array, but before that, I would like to tell you a little bit more about patterns. Excuse me. This is how it looks like. X is note on, hyphen is note off. There's a sustain. I've grayed it out because I'm not going to cover it tonight. But basically, it's a very minimalistic kind of notation that you use to tell Scribbletune what you want to do with the notation, with the notes that you want to play. So in the early example, like this one, we saw this pattern, X minus X minus X minus X. As I said, those are 16 over there. And that can be changed, obviously. If you imported that inside a DAW, like Reason or whatever, it would look like this. So on the top row, the red rectangles, they signify an X. And the empty ones signify a minus. So X minus X. So that's the pattern. Here's another pattern. X minus minus minus, X minus minus minus. So this is like a very typical 4x4 kind of a kick drum thing which happens in almost every dance track, right? So that's a pattern for that. Really sorry about that. OK. So so that's how it would look once you import it inside a DAW. That's a kick drum right there. Going back to our earlier example, which did something like this. As you can see, it's an array of notes. We'll write some specific notes over there. Like, this is the C major scale. So if you have dabbled with music, you may be aware of the fact that do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do loosely kind of transcribes to C, D, E, F, G, A, B. So a C major scale looks like that, C, D, E, F, G, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, and C from the next octave. The pattern is still the same, note on, note off, note on, note off. So let's see how that sounds. Yeah. OK. So we are getting nowhere close to getting musical so far. And I'm aware of that. But we'll get there. We're getting there. OK. So like I said, that was an array, right? C, D, E, F, that's an array. You don't need to, if you're just going to play a scale, you don't need to enter the notes. You don't need to remember the scale in the first place. Scribbletune has a third method. Like I was saying, there are three methods. The third method is called scribble.scale, which lets you directly get the scale that you want. So in this case, we want a C major scale. So you do scribble.scale, C major, and it's going to do the same thing. The pattern is still the same. If I play that out now, it's doing the same thing, right? Now, scribble.scale returns an array. So since it's an array, you can do array functions on top of it. So what I'm doing here is, it's the same thing. It's scribble.scale, C major, it's getting a C major, and I'm just putting a filter on top of that. And what I'm doing is, I'm just taking the alternate notes in that C major scale. So I'm just doing X modulo 2, if it is equal to 0, then I'm letting it pass through, or I'm just missing it. So what that will do is, it will give me the alternate notes from that C, D, E, F, G, A, B. It'll give me C, E, G, and B. Yeah. So let's play that. So it's different from the before, from the earlier thing, because it's alternating notes now. Now, since it's an array, I can create two clips. One that takes the notes whose indexes are exactly divisible by 0, and the ones which are not. And I can create two clips. And then I can concatenate them, because they are arrays, right? I can concatenate them. And then I can play them. I can export them as MIDI. Yeah. Still nowhere close to, and nothing to do with electronic dance music so far, right? Yeah, electronic dance, and then so, okay. I think let's make some noise, okay? So I'm going to get out of the presentation, I mean the PowerPoint presentation thingy, and go to, are we recording? We are not recording. I'll just close this anyways. Okay, so yeah, before that. Okay, so this is Ableton Live. Like I mentioned earlier, you can use anything you want. It's you're not limited to one software or the other. You can use GarageBand if you like. So what I've done right now is I've put a set together, and I've put the basic sounds that I want to use tonight. For example, no sound, okay. This is ridiculous. Okay, hopefully that'll work. So there's a bass line over there. I have a percussion kind of sound, okay. I have a kick sound. That's a powerful kick, isn't it? So it took me some time to get that kind of, you know, energy in that kick. It took me a long time. I had to layer a bunch of kicks, play with compression, do some EQ and stuff. But finally, I got it. So, and then I have a snare sound. So these are typical sounds that you'd hear in any dance track. There's a clap sound. There's a hat sound. There's a crash, like a splash kind of a cymbal sound. Yeah. And there is a thin synth kind of sound, a string section. Yeah, we need that somewhere. And then there's a like a fat synth kind of sound. Yeah, so I've got these 10 odd instruments laid out as a set. And what we're going to do is we're going to use Scribbletune, obviously. And we're going to create these clips, like I said earlier. Scribbletune has these methods. One of them is clip. Clip is like a container of a musical idea. So we're going to create these clips, get them inside Ableton Live, and construct like a miniature kind of electronic dance track. We cannot do a full-on like 8-minute track, a twisted psytrance kind of track, but we can do a miniature kind of a thing. So let's see where it goes, OK? I'll create a file and, OK? So let's get started. So this is the very basic line that you'd write when you're doing any Node stuff. I'm going to require Scribbletune. Okay, bear with me. And I'm going to create a percussion kind of, let's start with a percussion kind of a loop, okay? I'm going to use scribble.clip. That's the method that we use to create a container of a musical idea. It takes notes as one of the parameters, as we saw in the earlier slides. I'll just give it C2 for now. That's the C note on the second octave. OK, and let's give it a pattern. Let's give it, I hope this works. OK, let's try that. OK, let's just render this out. By render, I mean let's create a MIDI file out of that, which is simple, like scribble.midi. And you give it the clip. The clip is perk, OK? And we'll execute that. Okay, it created a file called music.mid, which will pop up here, which it did now. I don't know if you can see it. A music.mid file got created. You can obviously set the name that you want. This is just a default. For now, it's enough. So let's just import that over here. Let's put it over here, and let's see how it sounds. Okay, first things, it's too small. It's too short. I mean, so the first thing I want to do is just double it up, because it's too small, OK? And another thing, if you notice, if a percussionist is actually playing, they're not going to hit the instrument with the same velocity every time, right? It's going to change. We're human beings. So I'm going to introduce something called sizzle. It's a property. Behind the scenes, it's just using a math.sign kind of a function to create a wave for the volumes of each of the notes. And then I'll use something called shuffle. So what shuffle does is, it just randomizes whatever notes you pass, and I'll pass it some more notes. So C sharp 2 is a chromatic, okay, and D sharp 2. So and what we'll do is we'll just duplicate this. Obviously, I can abstract some code out, make a function out of it. But for now, let's just keep it simple. We'll just affect the pattern a little bit, okay, and let's keep everything the same and concatenate. Okay, let's see how that sounds. And we have a shuffle there, so that means it's going to create slight variations every time we execute it. Let's see how that sounds. Yeah. So I don't like that too much, so I'm just going to execute it again. And then I'm going to pull it in again, because it's a shuffle, right? It's going to create a slight variation. The advantage of using JavaScript to do all of this is that you have a musical idea, you can pass some dynamic element to it, and get more out of your idea. That's the best part. I don't like this one as well. So. Yeah, this is fine. This will work. OK? Let's create a baseline. And let's create a very simple baseline. Let base is equal to, again, the same drill, scribble.clip, right? And then it takes one object. It has an array of nodes. Let's give it F sharp, okay? F sharp on the second octave, all right? And let's give it that pattern that we saw for the first time in one of those slides. The pattern is going to be X minus X minus. I don't need to do that. I'm not a sprint monkey. I'm going to do X minus dot repeat, and I'll just repeat that 8 times. If you do a quick math, 8 multiplied by 2 characters, that's 16-bit, okay? So let's render that out. Scribble dot MIDI. By render, I mean create a MIDI file. And we'll pass it the base, okay? And execute that, and bring that inside Scribbletune. I'll just solo this channel, and let's see how that sounds. And obviously, I intend to play it with the percussion. Okay? Now, we have the base. Let's get in a kick, okay? I'll just copy this thing over here, paste it. We can abstract all of this out, but I just want to show you what I'm doing so that.
Sizzle on the kick.
Yeah, we will. Okay, so I'm changing the pattern a bit over here. So the notes, okay, here I want to specify something. So notes C4, that's the middle C. Kick or a snare or a splash or a hi-hat. It's a single stroke kind of a instrument. It's not like a piano where there are multiple notes, or it's not like a percussion kind of, like a drum kit with multiple instruments. It's just one hit. So that's why I'm sticking to the middle C. Most DAWs kind of understand that, and they will play the sample that you use on middle C just the way it is. So I'll export this guy. Let's see. Okay. And then I'm going to create one. Let's create something else. Let's create a snare drum. Okay. And we'll change the pattern a bit. We'll do, we'll get rid of this and then. Okay. Oh, I didn't do any X. Okay. X. Okay, so it's just going to have one snare, all right? And let's export that and bring that in on the snare channel. Maybe I'll put it over here, okay? And then let's do a clap as well. Please bear with me, I know this is taking time. But the results are good. So, and instead of this guy over here, I'm going to do 1, 2, 3 over here. And execute that. And bring that in. Clap. And one last thing is the hats. So maybe we can take it from here. So it's a little bit faster. This is the last thing. Oops, what did I do? Okay. Hats. And we'll change this a bit. Okay. And import that inside the hats channel. we'll duplicate this stuff because we like it. We tried a bunch of things before we settled on it. And then we'll duplicate the base over here. So let's see what we got so far. Okay, that's not bad, is it? Okay. So what I want to do is, what we did was we created a percussion, we kind of ornamented it with some rhythm section around it, and we built up a beat, right? This is going to be a miniature kind of electronic dance music track. It's not going to be like a full-on thing, but it's a miniature one, so we're going to have all those elements that are involved in making electronic dance track. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to divide this whole track into three segments. This is the first segment. It starts out with that percussion and then the bass line and then the kick drum and all that. And then what I want to do is I'm going to do a part which I'm sure you must have heard in countless electronic dance tracks. It goes like and then, you know. So let's write that. So that's the last thing I'm going to do for this segment. And in this case, the pattern is going to be like all downbeats. And 16 of them. So this pattern is like XXXXXX 16 times. So, and again, it's the C4, the middle C. And we'll call it rise. Okay? All rise. And then we'll export that. Let's see how that sounds. I'm going to put it on the snare channel, solo it out. It's going to sound a bit jarring. Please bear with me. Okay. Please don't cut the sound. I hope you didn't. Let it be jarring for some time. I'll stop it. So what we want is we want a rise kind of a thing. So the volume kind of starts at the lower end and kind of goes up, that kind of a thing. So what we can do to achieve that is there's something called accent map. I won't get too much into accent maps, but it lets you use the xn minus n underscore syntax to kind of accentuate certain notes. And it also takes an array of numbers so that you can explicitly say what volumes do you want on each of those notes. So I'll use the latter. So I'll start with 5 and I'll go up to 120. So 5, 10, okay, 50. I could have written a function that returns that, but that's fine. And then, so that's, is that 16? So 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, yeah, that's 16. And let's render that. Let's bring that in. So as you can see, I've kind of opened up the piano roll for it. It's that gradation suggests that it's going from low to high kind of thing. Okay. I'll close that. And for these three, we'll just bring them down over here. And these two as well. And let's see what we've got. Oh, it's solo. Bless you. Let that go for some time and then we'll go into the melody line. Okay, so that's the part I wanted to build. So that's segment one. Let's go to so as you can see, I'm writing something and then putting things around it. So we'll continue to do that, but I won't keep on typing it again and again because I'm running out of time and I don't want to piss the next speaker off completely. So a little bit, just a little bit, not too much. I assure you that. So let's create something called the verse. Okay, so we'll call it the verse section. It's the middle section of our stuff. So I've written some stuff I'll write along the way. So obviously, let's start with obviously scribble is equal to require Scribbletune. Okay, and let melody. Let's call it melody. Scribble dot clip. Obviously, same drill again. And what we'll do is we'll use that scale method that we used some time ago for the notes. It returns an array. So scribble dot scale, and we'll use F sharp minor scale. Okay, you don't have to even remember what the notes are for F sharp minor. You can just tell Scribbletune to give it to you, and then we'll slice it up. Since it's an array, we can use the array functions, and we'll just take the first four nodes of it. And we'll use this pattern on top of it. Let's just render that and let's see how it sounds. Okay, scribble.midi and then melody. And let's give it a name. Let's call it verse melody.mid. And let's execute that. And let's see how it sounds. So I've got a melody channel like I showcased a little earlier. And this is how it sounds like right now. Okay, so basically it's the first four notes of the F sharp minor scale. We obviously want it to be a little longer, so we'll do like repeat at least four times. And then we'll create one more clip. And instead of F sharp minor, we'll do G sharp Phrygian. So these are modes. So scales are also called as modes. And I don't want to get too much into technical aspects of music theory, but all the modes and scales that you can think of are available on Scribbletune, and you can just use them. So Phrygian is a pretty nice, I like that mode a lot. I compose a lot in that mode. And we'll just concatenate these two. And let's see how that sounds. So it's going to be a little bit longer than the earlier because it has two things now, as you can see over here. Okay, now we'll create some chords. But what I'll do is I can keep typing like this, but I have written some part already. Maybe we can just use that for now so that I can save some time and show you what I want to, like, you know, in this track, like what all you can do with it. So I'll just export this out. I'll just show you what I was going to write. So there's a new baseline I wanted to introduce at this point. And I wrote one function called getChord. So what it does is it lets you provide the chord that you want, and it creates a clip out of it. And it exports it as verse strings, and it gives and it takes these chords, C sharp suspended 4, D major, B minor, E major, and all that in the fifth octave. So without getting too much into the complexity of that, let's just do node verse, okay? It'll create a bunch of MIDI files, as you can see over here, and we'll line them up over here. So verse.melody was this, verse.strings was this. So we're saving some time by doing this. It's no big deal. It's just the same process like we did some time ago. Snare. Clap, okay, clap. We wanted to introduce a new bass line, so verse bass. We can use the same kick drum kind of a thing, okay. And am I missing some hats? We can use the same hats for now. I didn't create new hats. And the chords, of course. We took the chords, right? Yeah. So I've got my bass, kick, snare, clap, hats. Okay, seems like okay. And if you remember, we got into this like this. Yeah. And this is the bass and the strings coming up. What we'll do is we'll reuse that rise thing again to get out of this segment as well and go on to the last segment of this track, which is the idea segment. So a song, a track, it's like a conversation. At least Hans Zimmer likes to call it a conversation. It's like a story. So so this part, right? It's like some questioning is going on. Someone is asking some questions. Why this and why that and why is my life like this and all that? So we'll do that for a bit. And then we'll rise out of this and we'll go on to the idea part, which is the answer to everything. It's the objective of this song. So so it's like a synth kind of riff. And to get there, we'll use the same parts because it's repetitive music. It's electronic dance music. What we'll do is, you remember the snare part we did? We'll just reuse that again for now. You could have obviously written another one, but For now, we'll just keep it simple. And we'll get out of that part with OK. And we'll write a synth kind of melody now, like a riff kind of a thing. And let's call it outro. OK? OK. So what I'm going to do is, obviously, scribble is equal to require scribble. I should have copied this earlier, sorry. OK. And we'll create a function that gives us a riff. OK? And it takes a single note, which we later take and concatenate, I mean, put it together with two other notes. OK? So notes. So that starts with the note that we pass to it. And then we do maybe a G sharp on the fourth octave and a A4, A note on the fourth octave with this pattern. And we'll repeat that 8 times. So it's slightly longer. That's 32. So that's like twice the length. And what we'll do is we'll do scribble.midi. And we'll take that riff function. It's a function, right? It returns an array. We forgot to do something over here. Scribble.clip business. We forgot that. Yeah, that should do it. I don't have JSCS hint running on this, but still, what the hell? And then get riff. And we'll give it one note to start with. We'll give it F sharp 4. And let's just render that and see how it sounds. So node outro creates, did I give it a file name? I did not give it a file name. Let's give it a file name. Let's call it outro synth.mid. Render that and bring that in onto the and to that fat synth sound that I had earlier. It sounds something like this. OK, it's a one octave high, so I want to get that down. Maybe it should be 3. OK. Yeah. OK, so since it's a function, now it can take multiple things, right? Let f is equal to, we'll take this guy, get riff from here, and we'll put him over here. And we'll create 3 more like this, 3 more clips like this. It's a function, so it's going to give out those clips for us. We'll do F sharp, and then we'll do E. And then we'll just go backwards a bit. Then we'll do D, and then we'll do C sharp. And we'll call this guy E, this guy D, and this guy C, OK? And here we'll just concatenate all of these things, F dot concat. I'm sure we can come up with some intelligent way of concatenating instead of this, but that's fine for now. So we're just putting these clips together into one MIDI file. Let's export that. And let's bring that in again. And here's the piano roll for it, under it. OK, so this is my riff. This is my capital idea of the song. And I want to introduce it with a kind of a bang kind of a thing and bring up a new kind of rise. We'll reuse the earlier rise, which I think we've already set up. I will not type out all of these things. I've kind of put it together, so I'll just execute it so that I can save time because it's already 7:39. OK, and then I'm going to bring in a new bass line, a new clap or something. And the most important thing, I'm going to bring in a new build-up kind of a, you know, you must have heard it in many dance tracks, like a kick drum build-up. It's nothing but just a long pattern. If you see this guy, it's a long pattern. And we'll apply that on a kick. The process is still the same. It's just scribble.clip, put some notes in there, attach a pattern, export it as MIDI. It's the same thing. So I've exported that now. And I've got all of this inside here. Let's just bring it together. I hope I don't screw up. OK, so outro kick break. Oops. So this is the break thing that I want to do. OK, we'll do it over here. And then I want outro single hit. OK, we can do that on a crash. Then we'll do a baseline, a new baseline. OK, this is fine. This is going in the right direction. And then a new snare. Or maybe we can just reuse the snare, right? And then we'll do a hats, a new hats, a new clap. OK, and this is the moment where I can like screw it up like in a very big way, but I'll go for it anyways. And then, OK, massive lead. And where's my synth break? Synth break, OK. And my synth. What else have I got? Melody? What melody? Ah, there. Thank you. Outro melody, and I don't need strings. Maybe I can reuse this guy. Outro hats, we can reuse them over here. Outro hats, we can use them over here. I think I've got it down. OK, I didn't miss anything. I hope I don't screw up. OK, so should I just go for it, or should I check it out? OK, so let's go from the top, OK? OK, I hope I have not screwed it up. This is our track. This is our track. Okay. So let's bring in a new baseline and a strings. Yeah. So this is a capital idea of the track. And then we'll go into a break that I've still not heard. I hope it works out. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, so that's it. The day is not far when Node.js engineers will rule the world. Thanks, thank you, thanks. That's it. And yeah, and I promise I'll show you that it can solve the security problem, right? So yeah, that's the way to do it. You keep your neighbors awake. An awake neighborhood is a safe neighborhood. And if you like it, please star my repository. You're sitting inside GitHub, might as well do it. OK, thank you. Thank you very much.